There was an integral that came up in the Center of Mass 3D Part 2 video, and I mentioned that there would be a video for that, and this is that video. For the purpose of that Part 2 video, I just used Wolfram Alpha. Now we're going to work it out completely by hand. So here is your integral, and it has this piece in it, which reminds us of this. So we're going to go with a sine type of substitution. So I just made it be, here's what I want on the y side, on the opposite, dividing by some constant, and put the z here, so that z squared plus square root of r squared minus z squared will be, when you square that, you're going to get r squared, so it all works out. Okay, so now we see that z over r is adjacent over hypotenuse, so that's cosine of that angle, and that implies this, and then you differentiate with respect to theta, dz d theta, you get this. And you move the d theta over and you get this. So there's your dz substitution. But also, we have the sine theta is, of course, the side opposite over the hypotenuse. That's the sine. So that means that this part, you multiply the r over and you get this. And similarly, from this cosine statement, z solved there will be r cosine theta, so that z squared, because we need the z squared up here, z squared will end up being r squared cosine squared. So now we're ready to sub everything in. So you put all the pieces in for your integral. I factored out then the r squared and a negative to get this. So this is where you are. This integral is the same as the original. So now all you have to do is work with this one. So what I did was I just said, let's put the negative r to the fourth aside for a second. Just work on this. So here, and I chose to do sine squared as 1 minus cosine squared, and you come up with this in. And then you have your cosine reduction formula in your table of integrals. Cosine n power equals this. So for the squared, n is 2. So you put the 2 in there, that's how you get to half. And you work it down here. 1 half cosine to the 0 power, 2 minus 2 is 0, is just 1. And so that comes out 1 half theta. Integral of 1 is theta. So the cosine squared is here. And the cosine of the fourth integral works out very similar in the reduction formula and comes out to here. Okay. So then, just completing this integral that we were working on here, it's equal to the cosine squared answer minus the cosine of the fourth answer. And here I multiply the 3/4 in to get the 3/8 over there. Okay, and then I simplify that down algebraically to this. So now, from above, we actually want negative r to the fourth times this. That's the integral from right here. So that's our real, the actual integral we're working on. So here we have. So what we do is we say negative r to the fourth times that simplified version from here. That's this right here. And then I factor out a 1/4 and left what's in there, trying to make it a little simpler. Then I remembered from above the definition of the z r cosine was z over r on the triangle. And sine theta was this on the picture. So substituting those terms in for where they belong here. Now, this one, theta, what do you do for that? So back on the picture, here was the picture. Here's your theta. So the tangent of theta is this term over z. So the arctangent of square root of this over z is the angle. That is the angle. Okay, so that theta is that arctan. Okay, so I plugged that in for what that was. Then I did a bunch of algebra. It was very dangerous. I came down to this step and I just wanted to combine. I saw this and this and they were the same, so I wanted to combine them in case it made it easier. You don't really have to. So this is just a factored out version after I doctored up this denominator to be 2 by doing that. And then I got my expression. Okay, then I remembered from part 2 video that this integral is what we really wanted for the during the center of mass of the 3D object. And it had this 3 over r cubed out there. So we now have our answer to the integral part. It's negative 1/4 out there. You hit it with this 3 over r cubed, and then you evaluate our expression 0 to r, and you better get the same answer as you did in the previous video, which was 3 pi over 16 times r was where the center of mass z value was. So sure enough, you plug in the r and you get a 0, and you get the arctangent of 0, which is 0, so that's just a big 0 there. And then you plug in 0, and this is where, similar to the other discussion in the other video, when you're plugging in 0 down here, the 0 makes this go to r in the top over something that's going to infinity in the bottom, that's going to 0. So the same discussion implies when you plug in the 0 down here, that's going to infinity, or going to 0, so the whole quantity there is going to infinity. And when you approach those large numbers, your angle, your arctangent, is going to pi over 2. Just like the same explanation in the other video. And so when you work that all out, because this is 0 there, you get the same answer exactly as previous. Now you want to notice that the antiderivative for what we worked out here is different than Wolfram Alpha gave, which means that the routine inside Wolfram Alpha used a slightly different trig substitution approach to work it out with. I mean, who knows what went on in that computer brain of theirs. So, but the final result was exactly the same. So you don't have to worry about that it looked a little different. Came out exactly the same.